One of the pillars of this channel is the Mongoose XR Pro, which turned into Project XR, my attempt to turn a Walmart Mongoose into a trail-worthy bike. And through its various stages, I'm quite happy with the results, and 2 years later, it's still going strong. The XR was just the tip of a much larger Mongoose iceberg, because I also added a Mongoose Malice Fat Tire bike to my stable and upgraded it as well. I have a 27.5 plus wheeled bike too, the Mongoose Ripsaw. And most recently, I was able to introduce the Stranger Things Max BMX bike and give everyone an early look. So I'm cool with having a Mongoose big box bike, though among them all, the XR stands out, both as a labor of love and also as a subject that's somewhat controversial. And I've had dozens of riders ride my XR Pro, and I've had almost a million watch my Project XR videos. And I'm often asked how the XR would stack up against a good mountain bike, and even more often, someone will make a comment about how Mongoose used to make real bikes before they were in Walmart. Mongoose does still make higher-end, non-big-box bikes, and I reached out to them for a shot at getting one to review and compare. And they responded with this, the Salvo Pro, a 27.5 full suspension mountain bike available on Amazon for around $2,000, a little less than 2K for the smaller frames and a little over that for the large. So the first question may be, knowing what big box Mongoose bikes are like, is it easy to see a difference? Oh yeah, but how about a modified big box bike? Well, let's look at a rundown of the Salvo Pro and see how it's equipped. And it starts with 720mm handlebars, but these aren't generics. These are Core XCD series with a 13mm rise. The Exposure headset includes a 60mm alloy stem, so not a 90+. This is a demo bike, so it comes with these comfort grips, but the factory bike has lock-ons. The brakes are Shimano Hydraulics, M447 series, and the shifters are Shimano SLX. More on both of these in a moment, because I want to get to something else first. And this goes out to all those people that say it's not a mountain bike without a tapered headset. Well, here you go, a Mongoose with a taper. And stuffed into that headset's a tapered fork, a Manitou Marvel Pro Air Fork. 120mm of travel, a remote lockout, and a through axle. And sandwiched by the fork is a 27.5 Helix wheel set by Sunringle. It's tubeless ready and fitted with Schwalbe Racing Ralph 2.25 inch tires. The hydraulic brakes have Shimano 180mm rotors on the front and rear. A nice setup up front, but there's more to this bike than a tapered headset and an air fork, because the rest, at least spec-wise, looks good too. This demo bike also didn't come with pedals, so I fit it with the new Bontrager Elites, which are their knockoff of Race Face Chesters, and ironically, the orange doesn't match any of the Trek bikes, but it matches the Salvo Pro's orange perfectly. Bottom bracket, that's a Shimano Holotech, along with a Shimano MT7000 crankset. It's a 2x3424. And shifting through those front gears is a Shimano SLX derailleur, and for the rear, there's a Shimano XT with Shadow Technology and M8000, and that works a Sunrace 11-42 11-speed cassette. The rear shock is always a focal point on full suspension bikes, and this one is equipped with a Manitou Radium Expert. Non-big box bikes, the pivot system is often criticized for being a weak point, but here it's very robust. Metal bushings on both the seat stay pivots and the chain stay pivots. And the chainstays themselves are a bit unique, with a twist on the right chainstay from one end to the other. On the opposite side, it's raised a bit higher than the right. I don't know how well this comes across on video, but in person, it's very noticeable. Two-tone orange graphics are clear-coated over the metallic burgundy frame, and they're kind of, well, there's plenty of graphics to be seen, but they're not over the top like on a cheap big box bike. The only thing anywhere on the bike that approaches a cheap out is on the frame cabling, because it's external, routed underneath the down tube. 2014 alloy. That's the 31.6mm seat post fitted with a Mongoose cross-country trail saddle. I don't know about to you, but this definitely looks pretty good to me, and most certainly not a big box bike, at least on paper. Here's all the listed specs. On the trail, this is pretty much a tell-all expose on what I like in a mountain bike. It's easy to get up to speed, and it's geared appropriately to easily maintain that speed, at least on flatter areas. It's no slouch on hills either. It's a capable climber, especially considering it's a full suspension bike. I've attested to my love of 1x, I like the simplicity, but unless it's a high-end 1x, a 2x actually works better on the local trails. Because we have lots of quick ups and downs that require a good range to enjoy comfortably, and for that, the gearing of this 22-speed 2x is near perfection. I don't know what the top speed is, because I'm not a speed demon, but this setup is certainly capable of some high-speed runs, especially with the aid of the air suspension. That Marvel Pro up front, it's easy to work with. There are 8 clicks of rebound adjustment, it has a pressure guide on the left side, and it was perfect when I matched the PSI with my weight. Didn't really have to do anything but find a rebound I liked from one of the 8 clicks. And the radium rear shock, it's also smooth, but it lacks a pressure guide of any kind, so I just kind of winged it. It did take some time before I could find a right pressure and setting combo. But once I hit that sweet spot, it's done a great job. The two air suspensions have kept things firmly planted, which is good, because the Racing Ralph tires, they work well on this trail, but they do get a bit squirmy on loose dirt. I've had this bike on the trail 3 times in the past week, and I'm confident enough on it that I've even taken a few non-Kev-like risks and came out fine, me and the bike. You'll likely be seeing much more trail footage of this because I like the Salvo Pro because, you know, there's something about this bike. I mean, the specs of a bike sometimes reel us in, sometimes it's the marketing or just the looks that might catch us. But then there are those bikes, the ones you just get on and you knew it was meant to be, but there's no explanation for it. Well, that's the Salvo Pro in me. Well, what about my $6,000 Cannondale? Is it better than that? Well, obviously not. It's not a $6,000 bike, but it does work and it works for me. And here's the thing. If I crash this $1,900 bike, it's not that big of a deal. If I crash a $6,000 carbon bike, that has a sting. Now don't get me wrong, an expensive bike can be great if it can be afforded, but Salvo Pro and bikes like this give me all the performance I need, but at a fraction of the cost, so that's more fun. Now some of this is due to more favorable elements that are a better fit for me, like 720mm bars versus 780+, and there are other things like those comfort grips that are surprisingly enjoyable. And the SLX shifting, just like the shifters on my Project X bike, are reliable and efficient. In all honesty, I never used the Manitou remote lockout on the trails, but it seems like it would work. I press buttons and things move. And that taper, well, it's not so much the strength that I'm interested in, but it is nice to have future fork options. And as far as forks go, this is my first Manitou. I've considered them in the past, but never committed. And this Marvel Pro, I like it so far. Rebound's easy to dial in, it holds pressure, and it keeps the front end controllable. Is it within the realm of a high-end Fox fork? Well, no. But I would rate it in there with the upper mid-level RockShox. I also find it funny with a name like Marvel that the logo looks a lot like Thor's hammer. Now you haven't seen it, but I've been running Racing Ralphs on Project X for the past few weeks and they're well suited here, but I feel like tires with a bit more bite would be a benefit for the Salvo Pro. Along with those Racing Ralph tires, the Sunringle wheels are tubeless ready. So that means if I ever need to, I can shave a pound or two off the bike, which comes in from the factory at around 32 pounds. These elite pedals, Bontrager nailed them, so look out race face. Rock solid. That would be two words to sum up the Holotech and the Shimano crank set. The front SLX derailleur hasn't given me any trouble, nor has the XT rear derailleur. It works through all 11 gears without chain slap. The Radium Expert works well, but it's still a bit of a curiosity because I can't really find any information on it, and I'll be posting updates as I get more experience with it. Its pivot mount system, though, has proven me to be solid, and in an upcoming video, I'll be taking a closer look at it and the bushings to see how serviceable it is. And that chainstay up and down configuration's grown on me, I'm not sure why other than it's different. With a 60-61 frame and coming in at 32 pounds, it's in line with other full suspension bikes in the $2,500 to $3,500 price range. And I'm confident that along with going tubeless, swapping out the seat post and handlebars for carbon, I could get it under 30. On top of that seat post is a racy looking saddle that's another unexpectedly comfortable item, and it also looks good with the matching graphics. Now I think the graphics look good, but they are kind of a like it or not item. They're not over the top, but they're definitely not subdued. One thing's for sure, whether it be looks or performance, this is definitely not a big box Mongoose. And for me, the Salvo Pro does two things. Number one, it's proof that Mongoose still has bikes that can hold up their legacy. And number two, that it's going to work perfect for what I had in mind, which is a direct comparison between Project XR and a higher end Mongoose bike. That'll be coming soon, so make sure you're subscribed and you have the notification bell active and comment below and let me know what you think about the Mongoose Salvo Pro and also if you like it that Mongoose still has higher end bikes. Thanks for watching, I hope you have a great day, and now enjoy a few pics of Kev Central subscriber bikes, fittingly starting with a couple of Mongooses.